Let's talk about that collapse. Give us an idea based on what you know, what you understand, your experience. If the banks don't take action, if Congress and regulators don't take action, what happens?
You have defaults across the board on whatever percentage of $16 trillion of mortgages, residential and commercial. Just in the commercial mortgage market, you have $4.5 trillion. And that money needs to keep recycling to keep people moving and the employers in their buildings so that they can hire employees. If that stops, margin calls at the banks to all the intermediaries, right? We talk about the non-bank banks and the shadow banks that after Dodd-Frank were instituted in order to create more liquidity in the system for mortgages. When that stops, everything stops. Because when the margin calls start, which is what's happening now, which is what happened in 2008, which is what happened in 1997, which is what happened in long-term credit, it's a momentary timeout. It's not a permanent impairment to value. What everybody needs is just a timeout. Give them 60 or 90 days, let it all come back together, tack on that accrued interest to the end, and you'll solve the problem. If we don't solve the problem in 90 to 120 days, we have a different set of problems. But the Fed is the lender of last resort. We always say don't fight the Fed. So them buying everything they can buy at the window, open up that window to commercial paper, open up that window to triple Bs, open up that window to more categories, they can do that. In the regulatory framework, Jay Powell, the SEC, Jelena McWilliams, they understand what to do. What they need is a...
What about the president? Everyone knows you're a longtime friend of President Trump's. You also know the Treasury Secretary, Steve Mnuchin, very well. Have you spoken to them about this personally? And if so, do they understand what you're describing and what are they prepared to do about it?
Look, I think one of the greatest things we have is incredible leadership at a really difficult moment. And I think President Trump is doing everything that he can do. He's armed his generals. He's all in. Steve Mnuchin is probably the best Secretary of Treasury we've had prepared for this moment. And he has people in every one of these regulatory bodies aligned and armed, and he's doing everything he can do to lay this map for Congress, which is complicated, right? It's not the idea, it's the regulatory framework within the law that needs to be done. And yes, they're all over it. What needs to happen now is the Democrats and the Republicans have to put politics aside and say, look, we have two wars. We have a health war and we have a financial war. Roll out all the tanks, roll out all the machinery, announce it to the market, and you'll probably never have to use it. The market just needs to know liquidity is not going to stop. It's not a credit crisis.
Tom, at the risk of sounding a little crass, you're highly self-interested in this matter. I know you care deeply about the future of the country and the future of the economy, but real estate and real estate credit are what Colony does. If the steps that you're calling for or some other relief measure isn't passed, isn't pursued, isn't taken, what do you stand to lose?
Well, I mean, look, the good news is Colony is in a great position. We have almost $3 billion of cash. We're in a great position to be able to withstand that. It's not what I'm worried about. What I'm worried about is how does the cafe employee, the restaurant employee, the drivers, the people who work in warehouses survive. They can't do it if the employers are gone. And we've been to this rodeo before. This is not self-interest. It's simple. This is what happened in 1998. It's what happened in 1989. It's what happened in 2008. And you have the best veterans who've been there, Mnuchin, Powell, Odding, McWilliams. The problem is they don't have a playbook from Congress.
So
they'll get it done. And if it doesn't happen, the evaporation at the employee level is going to, people can't pay their rent. If people can't pay their rent, then owners can't pay interest. If owners can't pay interest, the system collapses for nothing.